Well, hello and welcome. This is Laura Brandenburg for Bridging the Gap. And today we're here to answer a question from Monica. And she asked, what are the top 3 to 5 technical skills a business analyst with a business background needs to have? And specifically, she asked this around wanting to be able to make sure she could have good conversations with the technical people on her business analyst team, or the technical people on her project teams. So, and here's the thing about technical skills, and you've heard me say it before, and you're going to hear me say it again. You see them as job requirements a lot of times in business analyst roles, and a lot of times those requirements are extremely misleading. So you can, of course, to become more technically minded as a business analyst, you can learn how to write code, and you could go take an introduction to programming and a SQL course and learn a bunch of technical skills that you may never ever want to actually use in your career. You could do that, or you could learn some requirements models that allow you to have those very productive communications and conversations with technical professionals and understand more about how the technology is structured and give you insight into what questions to ask than the technical skills themselves actually do. So what I'm going to talk about here in terms of technical skills are actually 3 requirements models or 3 types of requirements models that you really might want to look at if you feel like you're not technical enough to be a business analyst. And then I'm going to finish with 1 closing bonus skill that might catch you by surprise. So let's talk about these 3 models. The first is use cases. So use cases are a textual description of how a business user or a user of a software application interacts with a software system. And they force you to get really, really specific about what function or feature that system needs to have in order to meet the business needs. And that feature, underlying that feature, is often a piece of code that a developer has created or customized or integrated in order to make that function work. But what you need to be able to specify as a business analyst is what that software needs to do and the conditions under which it needs to do it. And a use case is the perfect model to kind of get really familiar with that business user system interaction. It's much more detailed than a typical business process model, and it's much more specific, so you get into those specific technical requirements, even though you don't know how to write the code that underlies it. Now, the second requirements model that can be really helpful in expressing technical requirements like this are wireframes. And wireframes are visual descriptions or visual renderings of a user interface screen. And essentially, when I go to a software application as a user, what does it look like to me? And not specifically like what are the colors and what are the buttons and how are they, you know, circle or square, like that is important at a certain point of the project, but a wireframe can be much less specific than that. It can just use like general buttons and not be specific on colors, use grayscale. You're really trying to show this is what the user interface screen might look like to a potential user. So again, you're getting to that level of detail of what that software system needs to be able to do and look like, again, without having to write the code behind it. Because there are a lot of tools today that people like me who don't have coding backgrounds are able to use that just drag and drop those features into a wireframing tool so you can create them without actually having to know how to code. And the third set of models are data models, such as entity relationship diagrams, system context diagrams, data flow diagrams, data dictionaries. There's a bunch of different models included in the data modeling area. But essentially, all of those models allow you to understand how the database is structured, how information is stored, what information needs to be stored. So if you're looking at a business process and there's, you know, different fields on a form or coming in through some sort of an input, how is that information actually stored in your software systems? What are the rules that need to be applied when that information is stored? How does the different pieces of information that come in through different business processes, how do those relate together? Okay, and different data models allow you to look at that information model in different ways. And this is how you essentially learn how to model a relational database or express data requirements without knowing SQL. So an word, kind of not very well kept secret is that I've never learned how to write SQL. I did learn how to do a little bit of coding in a very proprietary database language that was very specific, you know, right at the very beginning of my career, but I've never learned SQL. I've never used that skill to move forward as a business analyst. I've done a lot of work with data requirements and data modeling and helped a lot of teams figure out what those data requirements and databases should look like by using some of the core data modeling skills. Okay, so I promised you one bonus. So our three models are use cases, wireframes, and data models. What's that bonus skill? The bonus skill is something that you're probably already good at if you're a business analyst, and that's the ability to ask questions. And really, when it comes to technical questions, it's like that ability to ask that question that you really feel like you should know, right? You should know the answer to this, and you don't, right? And it's asking questions about how things are organized, what are the capabilities of the technology, what are things that you might not think of, and you're using that so you can understand the possibilities of the technology and how the system is designed without actually knowing how to do it yourself. And in my experience, like, you could spend a lot of time learning how to build these systems and write code, and that could have a measurable impact on your career. Or you could spend time learning these core skills that you're going to use forever in your lifelong career as a business analyst, and they're going to actually give you a more advanced level of understanding of the potentials of technology than you would get from learning how to line by line create the code, because they're going to enable you to work in any sort of situation as opposed to just, you know, the coding language that maybe you learned. There's dozens of coding languages out there, dozens of different technical environments, and so you're never going to become the expert on all of them unless you actually want to be the expert and the doer of that kind of thing. And as you're a business analyst, I'm assuming you probably don't. So again, use cases, wireframes, data models, and having the courage to ask questions and get the answers to those questions so that you really have a good technical understanding in your environment. So those to me are the questions that you need to succeed as a business analyst with a business background in today's technical environment, and they will take you really, really far as a business analyst without getting you lost in the weeds of learning specific technical coding skills. So again, I'm Laura Brandenburg. I'm the creator of Bridging the Gap, and we are a provider of training for mid-career professionals starting business analyst careers, and we actually have courses and use cases and wireframes as well as data modeling and business process and BA essentials as well. If you'd like to learn more, go ahead and check out our website at bridgingthegap.com.